big that it would take beyond a human lifetime to journey across it. Space is so big that science fiction stories invented a technological trope to make the journey across intergalactic distances insignificant. Science fiction asks us to imagine, what if there was a special engine in a spaceship that could warp us across a galaxy? That's right. Today on Intergalactic Forms, we are talking about visualizing faster than light speed travel with visual effects. My name is Blake Rizzo. Let's dive right in.
Hello, welcome back to Intergalactic Forms. Today we're going to be creating some faster than light speed travel in Adobe After Effects with some Red Giant tools. Let's go ahead and create a new composition. Let's call this light speed jump. 1080p works, 24 frames per second, 15 seconds. That works great. Let's hit OK. And we're going to start by creating a new solid because we are going to be creating some intergalactic light speed lines as if we're kind of like moving through the galaxy and stars are zooming past us. So let's go ahead and create some light speed streaks. And then we're going to apply some Red Giant Trapcode Particular because we're going to be essentially creating a particle emitter that emits and shoots out stars towards us. So let's go ahead and go to Red Giant Particles in 3D in the Effects and Presets window. And we're going to go ahead and look for Trapcode Particular and drag it onto our layer. And immediately after it boots up, we can see that Particular is emitting particles. Let's go ahead and go to the Designer window. And let's go ahead and start designing our particle emitter for this light speed effect. Okay, so right out of the gate, I'm going to go ahead and go to the motion tab and turn off the velocity, set that to zero, velocity random zero, velocity distribution zero, just kind of zero out all these different things. So then now, essentially it will emit particles and then they won't move. I'm going to go ahead and also set the emitter type from a point to a box. So now it'll emit a box of particles. I'm also going to change the emitter size. I'm going to set this from XYZ linked to XYZ individual because now we can kind of adjust these into a shape of whatever we like. Set the emitter size, move them back. And what we're going to be doing is as this emitter generates particles, we're going to use an environment field to kind of blow them towards the camera to kind of create that streak. I'm going to then go to wind Z and set the wind velocity to a negative value. So that means as soon as they are emitted, essentially wind blows them towards the camera. Nice. Maybe turn that up pretty fast. We can now affect the emitter size, just kind of playing around with stuff a little bit. Maybe up the particles per second to up the density of particles. Nice. Okay, so now what we're going to make is we're going to make the streaks. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new system by hitting this plus button right here. Plus. We're going to go to emitter type, and we're going to select stroke from parent. And now, immediately, look at that. It looks like light speed. Okay, so right out of the gate, I want to control the length of the streaks. So we're going to go to our system two, which I'm actually going to rename real fast, call it streaks. And I'm going to go to the particle type, and under particle type, there's a particle life. And this actually affects how long the streaks live. So the longer the life, the longer the streak. So we're going to keep it kind of short. We're going to keep this like 0.5. Let's just go ahead and see what that looks like. Nice, that feels more manageable. Maybe a little bit more, maybe 0.75. 0.8, that works too. Cool. Nice, it feels like they're just kind of zooming past us. Right now they're all kind of very blocky white colors. We can also go to size and we can make sure that we say inherent size from parent. So that means if we change the size of our parent emitter, the primary system, it will affect the size of our streak. So I'm gonna go ahead and check that. I'm also gonna do the same thing from inherent opacity from parent as well. I'm also going to set the color of this particle to emit from the parent as well, because now if we go back to our primary system, we can start by essentially kind of randomizing these colors to kind of make them something interesting. I'm actually going to set a random from gradient, and we can use this gradient to kind of art direct the color palette of our stars. This is very cotton candy type of stars. For my light speed effect, I wanted to go with something a little different, and I wanted kind of some pale pastel warmish colors that feel almost like a carnival ride. I went with kind of a warmish white down to kind of more of a cherry red, and then changing to a dark blue. And you kind of see that it creates some nice colors in between. And then if I hit play, you can see that this will zoom by. Let's also change while we're here. Let's change the size of these. Let's also change the size random. So some of them are bigger than others. Let's also change the opacity random. I don't know. Maybe. Yeah, that feels nice. We're going to be adding a lot of glow to this because, as you can see right now, it doesn't feel like it's very glowy. And if we orbit our camera around, we can see what that looks like from the side, which is going to be kind of cool when we put our ship in front of it. One subtle thing before we start adding the ship, I decided for the streaks, I decided to add an opacity over life curve and kind of have it taper off the opacity so then it gradually becomes more opaque the further on the streak goes. I'm also going to add an opacity over life and change it from the beginning for the primary system particle. So then right when the particle emits, they kind of fade into existence instead of just appearing, you know? So that might look a little bit cleaner. Yeah, that feels a lot nicer. Because just imagine our spaceship in front of that thing, and it just, you know, we want to feel like it's got a really nice streak to it. Yeah, that's very fun. Okay, I like what we got going here. Let's go ahead and hit apply. And if we hit spacebar, we can see our particle animation that we just created. I mean, right off the bat, I already want to create a new adjustment layer and then apply an optical glow. As soon as I apply the optical glow, it's a little blown out, so I'm going to turn down the amount, change the size. I'm also going to change the vibrance so the colors kind of pop a little bit. Maybe also try highlight roll off, just kind of like dialing this in nicely. Turn down the amount, just kind of find that sweet spot. Oh, that's so fun. Yeah, let's throw a ship in front of it. Okay, let's go ahead and bring our ship in. Let's go new solid. We're going to use Geo. Go to effects and presets. I'm going to go down to Red Giant Particles in 3D, and it's right here. It's Geo. We'll go ahead and drag that onto our layer. It's going to give me the default sphere. I'm going to go choose model, and I have a model here for the cockpit glass. I'm going to go ahead and scale it up real fast. I'm also going to create a camera. Right-click, new camera, and let's do this with a 28 millimeter. Let's also set up some materials here. So I think material 2 is the glass. Let's see, roughness. Yep, that's glass. So I'm going to go ahead and go to surface presets, set this up to clear glass, and then I'm also going to turn down the transmission to hit that to 0, turn up the metallicness, roughness, set that to 0 as well. And now we have a reflective shiny glass here. We're going to use this to actually reflect the light speed lines. Okay, let's get this oriented here. Let's see, our streaks are coming towards the camera, right? So that means the cockpit needs to be kind of aiming towards that as well. So let's go ahead and go to Geo, rotate this negative 90 degrees, and we're going to want to also move the camera. I'm also going to move this closer. It feels like the first tutorial. Actually, that was the second tutorial. So let's go also, we're going to orbit the camera around. And we're going to try to get this set up in a way where essentially the light speed is zooming past the background of our spaceship. Zooming in. We could actually move all the particles to the back of the spaceship, which actually might be very good. So let's go ahead, zoom in. And right now for this shot, I just had it zoomed into the glass itself. So we might have to adjust where our particles go here in just a second. So I'm already feeling like we maybe need a wider lens here. Let's double click on the camera, zoom in. That's feeling a little better. I want to give a little more space for the background. Okay, so I'm already feeling like we need to move our particles a little bit. So let's go to our light speed streaks. Show systems, and we're gonna kind of position these into place. Yeah, okay, I feel like they can be a little closer. So let's kind of moving these around. That's feeling nice, I like that. Okay, so now let's handle the reflection. We're zoomed in right on a reflective glass, and right now it is not reflecting our particles that we made. We're actually gonna have to create our own 360 backdrop for the glass to reflect with particular in a different composition. I'm gonna go ahead and go up to our designer and take our particles. I'm gonna take our particles and I'm going to go ahead and save a preset. I'm gonna call this light speed particular. So we need to make an environment layer that's going to act as our background that the geo layer is going to reflect. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a right click, new solid. I wanna call this a background. For a background layer to work, we need to make the width to be twice as the height. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy and paste the width to the height. And we're gonna make sure that this is 2 times as big. So it's gonna be the width is 2160 times 1080. And we're gonna go ahead and hit okay. Awesome, this is gonna be our background. I always like to pre-compose this. So I'm gonna go ahead and pre-compose. Leave all attributes into light speed jump, yep. Boop. So then now, if I double click, we are now in a composition that is bigger. So let's go ahead and we're gonna apply particular to this layer. Now let's go to our designer tab and let's go ahead and go look for our preset, light speed particular. Okay, I'm gonna go hit apply. Okay, so immediately you could see that we need to restretch it back out. So let's go to primary system emitter and let's go ahead and change our emitter X and Y. Let's kind of zero this back out. Nice. So this is gonna be the environment that it reflects. So let's go ahead and let's go to our light speed jump and we're gonna go ahead and hide this and go to Geo. We're gonna go down to the environment tab, check animated environments, and we'll say environment map, custom, and we'll say environment layer, and we'll say background comp number one. And we'll say sources and effects and masks. So let's go ahead and just see what happens here. Okay, so immediately, do you see how all the lines are converging towards one point? So I've gone into a custom view here to kind of show what's going on here. We have all of the different lines are kind of converging into one point. This is, if we hop into the background comp here, this is the edges of our comp. That's like a seam where they're kind of connecting. Okay, Blake from the future here. I wanted to let you know that while I was making this tutorial, I learned a brand new technique on how to create fully 360 backgrounds with 3D plugins. I learned this after I kind of finished my scene. So I wanted to show you this technique now because it's really, really cool. But you'll see that my ship has already been composited and the glows are already applied. We'll get to that later on in the tutorial, but I just want to show you this because it's really cool. So ideally, we'd be able to create some type of 360 camera. And I didn't think this was possible until I found out you can. And frankly, ever since I've discovered it, my whole life has changed. If only we could have a 360 image that shows kind of the particles from all the different angles. Well, it turns out you can. So we're gonna go to our compositions, background comp one, and we go to composition. And the very bottom, there's this VR button. I've never hit this button before. I hit it today and check this out. It says VR, create VR environment. And we need to create VR from current composition. We're gonna say background comp one, and then we say, make sure that we set use 3D null camera control. And then we're also gonna say advanced settings. I am using 3D plugins. So particular is a 3D plugin. So go ahead and check that box. And then we're gonna hit generate VR comp. And let's see what happened. Like what? Wait, what? Oh man, I wish I knew about that years ago. But check that out. We have a fully 360. We just created a fully 360. So now let's go ahead and close this out. Let's go back to our light speed jump and where we're now going to change out our background comp to background comp VR output, and that's background comp one VR output, so that's our fully 360. We're gonna go back to our light speed jump. We're gonna drag this composition into our layer here, and check that out. That's our fully 360, and we need to go to Geo, and we're gonna say, hey Geo, environment, please take the custom refraction and environment map from our VR output comp, which is our 360. Let's go ahead and select that one. Select that one. And now check this out. Amazing. It completely creates a fully 360 image that can reflect in Geo perfectly without any weird scene problems. Amazing. Okay, now let's start compositing this to make it look a little bit more interesting, because right now it looks a little flat. Okay, so I've changed the highlight in the background for from the sun angle, just kind of giving it a rim light. Let's also quickly add some smudges on the glass. I'm going to right-click New Solid, add some fractal noise to that. I'm going to go to Geo, then we're going to go to the Roughness, and we're going to say, hey, Roughness, please be the smudges map. Then I'm going to kind of turn up the roughness just a little bit, because we're just trying to create some tiny imperfection on the glass that kind of makes it look kind of nice. Going to increase the tiling and then turn down the roughness so it's kind of subtle. Nice. One thing I'm also going to do is I'm going to go in the background comp and we're going to add some optical glow to this. And then we're going to soften this out. Zoom it in because it's nice and glowy. Yeah, that's looking really nice. We're going to up the vibrance on this. That's looking good. Now let's do some compositing with Supercomp. So I'm going to go ahead and select the Geo layer and the light speed streaks layer in the background. I'm going to right click on it, go to Effect, Red Giant VFX, Supercomp. And then now it's going to bring up a new composited layer called Supercomp. I want to add an optical glow on the background. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the Solo Plus tab, Optical Glow. And then what's really cool about Supercomp is the glow will actually kind of bleed over our foreground layer, which makes it look really realistic. I now start playing with the optical glow settings, increasing the vibrance and adding color correctors to add more contrast to my light streaks. I play around with light wrap, haze, until I get a look that looks like this. Oh, that's clean. In my final render, I added some camera shake and some magic bullet looks to kind of unify all the colors together. I'm really happy with how it turned out.
Thank you so much for watching Intergalactic Forms so far. As always, my name is Blake Rizzo. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you in the next one.